Dr. Ellie.
I think enough. Thank you.
Miss Jenny, you may I say little, you get greeting from Mem Asma.
Okay. Waalaikumsalam.
only so this. Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Miss Annie, for the conclusion, please don't use closing word. Maybe you can change to a conclusion or a summary, just like this, okay?
In your paper,
because I saw it, you use other word. It's like closing word. It's not appropriate in this paper, okay?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, miss.
Assalamualaikum. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. The next presenter is Miss Amita, Miss Susanti, and the others. Are you ready? Are you here?
Yes, okay. Miss Henny.
Okay, Miss Amita will present about the use of the footwear in the event of foot deformity in the type 2 diabetic mellitus patient. Time is yours.
Thank you, Mrs. Henny, the honorable ladies and gentlemen. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. I'm Dita from the Stikes Bakti Husada Bengkulu. In this research, I'm joining with Mrs. Desi Susanti, Mrs. Peri Zuliani, Mr. Nunu Harrison, and Mrs. Yatima. The title in this research is use of the footwear in the event of foot deformity in type 2 diabetes mellitus patient. I'm so sorry if spell English not good.
It's okay, don't worry about that.
Please next. So for introduction, in the world, from the World Health Organization in 2020, diabetes was the seventh leading cause of death in 2016. Diabetic foot ulcers have a prevalence of 5 to 10% and an incidence of 6.3% and annual incident of 1 to 4%. In Indonesia, the National Basic Health Research or RIKES does report that DM cases have increased from the 2013 or in 6.9% and two in the 2018 and 8.5%. Diabetes is a leading cause of blindness, kidney failure, heart attacks, strokes, and lower limb amputation. In Bengkulu province, people with DM increase prevalence from the 0.9%. 1.5% at in the 2018. Please next. Statement of problem. Diabetic foot ulcers are caused by repetitive stress in patients with peripheral neuropathy, foot deformities, and peripheral arterial disease. Foot deformity was identified as a risk factor for foot ulcer in diabetics. Poor foot care is a risk factor for diabetic foot complication, especially in the use of inappropriate footwear that can facilitate the occurrence of diabetic ulcers. The selection of the right footwear for people with diabetes mellitus with the risk of diabetic complication needs attention. If the patient wears footwear that is not appropriate, for example, too small, it can irritate the feet caused by the friction that occurs on the patient's feet when walking. If this is not prevented, it will result in diabetic foot injuries. Next, please.
Miss Amita, sorry. Could you skip this part and then next to the result and discussion, please?
Okay.
Thank you.
Next, please. Mr. Andre, yes.
Mr. Ari?
Excuse me. Yes. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Ari. For the result in this research, the table one characteristic of type 2 DM patient based on gender, foot deformity, and use of footwear. It is known that the characteristic of respondent based on gender in the large number of women are 44 respondents or 80%. Observation shows that a small proportion of respondents had put deformity in the form of callus and hallux valgus, and then 5.5% had flat feet. 3.6% of the DM patient had hallux limitus and hallux rigidus. 1.8% had pericae plantar. A small proportion of the DM patient use poor footwear is 29.1%. Next, please. For the characters of respondent by age, the average age of the respondent in this study was 49 years, with the youngest age being 21 years and the oldest being 98 years. Next, please. I'm sorry. Any silly mistake in the slide. The relation between the use of the footwear and the incident of foot deformity. At the deformity column, kebalik, Mrs. The deformity, yang deformity itu seharusnya ada. Bukan deformity maksudnya, yang no deformity yang deformity gitu. I'm sorry. Based on the result of the cross table between the use of footwear and foot deformity in the type 2 DM patient, it is now that from 39 patients with good footwear use, most of them, 35, did not experience foot deformity, while from 16 patients with footwear use unfavorable. Most of them, 12, had foot deformity. From the result of the chi-square test, p-value of 0.000 using the alpha of 5%, which means that there is a relationship between the use of footwear and foot deformity. Next, please. Discussion. The average age in this study was 49 years, 11 of out of 16 people identified had foot deformities on average over the age of 50 years. Researcher observed that DM patients aged over 50 years were more at risk of developing foot deformities than those age under 50 years. A previous study which was in line with the research states that the average age of the sample was 64.9 years, and patients with diabetes mellitus experience foot deformity. Then the result of another study found that the average age of the patient who experienced foot deformity in the study was 64.6 years. Please next. The result of study found the woman experienced more foot deformities than men. Previous studies explained that the female gender experienced greater foot deformity than men. The result of previous studies also explained that the female gender was associated with the incidence of foot deformities. The researcher concludes that the habit of women having a more modern lifestyle than men, where they use shoes, women tend to be pointed at the front, so the finger don't have enough space to move. Next, please.
Miss Amita, I'm sorry, the time is over.
Oh, sorry. Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you so much for your presentation. Okay. The next part, Dr. Ellie, could you give some question, please?
Okay. Good luck for your presentation.
Thank you, ma'am.
Your presentation is interesting, and the topic raised are also, I think, something that will be very useful for the community. Something you will need to add later in your article, who is the population and the analytical technique used. And then from result of the study, it turned out that from the number of your respondents, it turned out the female sex dominate, which is associated with the lifestyle of using women's shoes, which tend to be pointed at the foot. My question, from the studies you have studied, does the habit before suffering from diabetic mellitus also affect the change in the shape of the feet when experience the end? Furthermore, what can you do about the implication of the result of these researches so that it can be useful for the community? Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Ma'am Nur Eli.
I hope you know what I mean.
Little, ma'am. the number one about population. Yes,
yeah.
Population.
The number one is suggest.
About population. Number two.
Yeah. Pertama, Anda masukkan, hendaknya masukkan ya, supaya ada kejelasan siapa subjek studinya serta teknik analisis yang dipakai.
Yeah.
Kedua, itu pertanyaan, silakan.
Yang kedua tadi tentang
pembahasan. Di pembahasan Anda mengatakan bahwa karena hasil penelitian ini riwayat ya perubahan kaki itu ada pada wanita ya, lalu di pembahasan Anda mengaitkan dengan adanya kebiasaan kebiasaan wanita yang menggunakan sepatu yang runcing ya di bagian depannya. Nah, apakah kebiasaan ini tidak mempengaruhi perubahan bentuk kaki manakala dia mengalami atau menderita diabetes mellitus?
Iya, baik. Thank you for the suggest, Mem Nur Eli. I will add about the people population, maybe more criteria inclusion and exclusion, yeah, Mem. Yeah. For the question, why the about riwayat perubahan? Because in the result from the research, more women have the deformity and have experience use the footwear yang sempit dan yang tidak dan kurang lembut, yang seharusnya kan yang dia pakai itu yang lembut, kemudian yang tidak memberikan tekanan pada jari-jari. Dilihat dari sana, dari kuesioner, bahwa dari hasil jawaban pertanyaan dari mereka banyak yang menggunakan alas kaki yang sempit dan tidak memperhatikan kelembutan dan juga ruang untuk jari-jarinya juga, dan dipakai secara lama gitu. Kemudian and the next question, how about implication? Yes, ma'am. Untuk implikasinya pada penelitian ini, bahwa pada hasil penelitian ini penting untuk diketahui nanti pada responden ataupun pasien DM untuk ya, mengetahui
mungkin bisa dimasukkan di saran ya.
Oh, baik. Oke, okay. Terima kasih, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.